Hi everybody, CyberF here. I just wanted to do a video on Trump trial, lawless lawyers, and liars. And today is the final day of the second impeachment trial of Donald J. Trump. He's the former president of the United States of America. And as you can see on your screen, I wanted to capture some of the real truth and real Donald Trump that if anyone who has been watching the trial or the impeachment trial this week, I don't think, personally, myself, I don't think that they have struck truth. I don't feel that they have really looked into who Donald Trump really is, or what he is really about. And this is why I wanted to do this video. I wanted to do this video just to sort of put out my opinion, put out my thoughts and analysis of not just the impeachment trial, but looking over the whole 4 years of Donald J. Trump being in office of the United States of America. One thing I wanted to say is this. I have not heard the word coup. I have not heard the word coup. And the image on your screen, you've got Donald Trump holding up the Bible. Well, it doesn't actually even say anything on the actual cover, right? You see this? It doesn't say anything. There's no title. There's nothing on that Bible. Or supposed Bible. Is that another stunt of Donald Trump? Looks like it, if the photo is real. But this photo on your screen, Donald Trump as former president intended for this photo to be historic. The point I'm making here is that most of what Donald Trump intends to do is, if you're speaking law, and I am not a lawyer, I am not really interested in lawyers. That's why I think that most lawyers play games with laws for and against, regardless of whether who they're defending is actually guilty, 100%. Their job is to get that person off the charges and free in court. Donald Trump is no different. Donald Trump is on trial for impeachment a second time, and it looks as if he's likely to be acquitted and not convicted Donald Trump, just like the stunt of holding up a Bible or a book with no title on it, is exactly that. More a liar than anything else. And that is not an open accusation. That is a historical evaluation of Donald Trump. Even before the presidency, look at the University of Trump. Look at all the loans he's taken and not willingly or truthfully or honestly paid back. He loves bankruptcy. He claims to be a bankrupt or bankrupt specialist, right? You know, people who know business know what that's all about, okay? And he has said from his own mouth that he's made fortunes from debt. Really, what he should have said is, I've made fortunes from declaring bankrupt after I've borrowed millions of dollars or foreign currency. But we're speaking here about Trump trial, Lawless lawyers and liars, and most of Congress and the Senate and governments around the world are made up of attorneys and lawyers. People who are supposed to know the law, uphold the law, uphold the Constitution. In fact, the Constitution is more important than any person, regardless of your education, background, status in the United States of America. And it is the United States of America. So how does Donald Trump, with his reality TV show background, with made up lies and fabrication of his education, when people around the world and most people on planet Earth are not as illiterate, not as a liar than Donald Trump? Donald Trump abuses intelligence. He abuses common sense to the point that he would make a phone call to Georgia, state lawmakers, and ask them to find me votes, 11,000 plus votes, and just tell the citizens and people of America, you recalculated. That's not just abuse of power. That's an abuse of common sense, because you've got caught in the act. You made that call yourself, which now in 2021, the district attorney of Georgia, Fulton County, I think it is, they're now pressing charges or probing a criminal investigation into that phone call, into that mindset, that of intent, etc. and Donald Trump is on trial. Okay? The only president to be impeached twice in 1 year or one term. On your screen, you can see that even Fox 5, or the Fox Network, says here that Trump says he'll fight like hell to hold on to presidency. And lawyers or liars tend to play with words, right? But it says here, if they want to look at intent, in which, you know, they seem to be stuck on the intent of or mindset of Trump. They seem to be stuck on that. Some of the best attorneys, the best lawyers, the best policymakers. How can you get stuck on the intent when you know notoriously throughout 4 years of Donald Trump, he's lied nearly every single day? Check his tweets. Check his social media accounts. And right here on your screen, Fox reports that a tweet, and look at the date. It says here, Trump says he'll fight like hell to hold on to presidency. And that is exactly his intentions, his intent, and exactly what he did. One thing I can say about what I've seen over the years, and that's more than 4 years of watching and dealing with Trump online, which he has forced down the throats and the minds of people around the world, whether they are interested in him or not, is that when he says he's going to do something, he pretty much does it, regardless of how criminal, insane, racist, idiotic, evil, wicked it is. He seems to almost like just speak straight out of his brain or his ass. And he doesn't care. He doesn't apologize. Because if you can literally create this reality TV show where you see this fist here, and you add all the pieces to it, where did Donald Trump get this fist from? This fist of power, this fist of salute. And he's going to say, well, okay, I'm doing it because the Black Panthers did it. And black people do it. But he's doing it for a reason. And he thinks people are stupid. He thinks that they don't understand what he's really doing. And this is what should have come out in the impeachment trial. Donald Trump knows what he's doing. Donald Trump intentionally, with intent, has put together a group or army of or mob of people to carry out not just insurrection, but a coup on the Capitol of the United States of America. Period. The facts are there. And who has mentioned this fist, this salute that he's done repeatedly? There's lots of photos in the public online with this salute. And some people have taken the salute further to even replicate Hitler. Okay? Donald Trump knows what he's doing. Donald Trump knows what he's representing. The Republican Party, when you speak of the word insurrection, it's not in the history of the United States of America that Democrats have been notoriously known for insurrections, right? But when it comes to the Republic and the Republicans, they are notoriously known for insurrections. They know and stand behind the Confederate flag. Right? They know what slavery is about. They actually created, or can claim to have created, if you're talking about Democrat or Republican, it's the Republican Party, the GOP, that have pushed, created, enjoyed, even the KKK, slavery. And there's a history in the United States of America when it comes to the Ku Klux Klan, the KKK, being part of government, part of GOP, part of the Republicans. And this is what needs to be discussed at the core of this impeachment trial. Because what Donald Trump is doing is saying, look, I don't want you as a Democrat or as Congress or as Senate to take away the rights or tools or strategies of the GOP or Republican Party. I don't want that. I want the fist. I want the march. I want the Proud Boys. I want the KKK. I want far-right policies, strategies, and tools to rule in America. That's what Trump's saying. That's what Trump wants to do. That's why Trump says he'll fight like hell to hold on to the presidency. Because Donald Trump wants to rule America and the United States of America. In fact, Donald Trump actually said, and I heard him say, I just can't find it right now, but I heard him say he will be the last president. Not only that, if you can make millions from being the president and all your family, like Ivanka Trump reportedly, it said that she has made something like, what, 600 million? That's without even a salary? Anyone with business sense and acumen or intelligence is going to know what that's about, okay? How do you make 600 million? Doing what? And then you create a title of first daughter. First daughter. Are you the first daughter that's made nearly $750 million? How do you do that? that could be a whole video right there. But I wouldn't waste my time on that subject. But also, let me just give you a clue as to how you may get 600 million and more. If you're declaring 600 million because you know you're already under investigation, the Trump organization is already under investigation in New York and D.C. over electoral spending and your taxes and your organization. So how did you get 600 million when most of the Trump family, when they actually went into office or he won the presidency, how much money did they have then? All of them combined. I think they were in debt. If you check the records and do some research. So how you may get 600 million is just a loan. You could just do some quid pro quo. Or you could put a deal between Israel and Palestine. Move the scales towards Israel. I'm sure Israel will give you some money or deposit some money somewhere for you in offshore accounts, etc., to rule over the Palestinians, right? It doesn't take a lot of brain to work that one, huh? It's just you selling people. Okay. This is why Donald Trump, right here, when they were looking at the impeachment trial and they were trying to work out when did this all start, which really has still not been addressed, even though it's the final day of his impeachment. Now, also what I want to say about this impeachment trial is it's just a bunch of comedy, circus, disrespect for truth and honesty of law and laws of any country, because how can you claim that this is not a trial when someone has literally on video with a lot of evidence, okay, from the person's mouth and actions, literally as sitting president of the United States of America, has literally attacked the very building, capital, government that he swore an oath to serve and protect and uphold, which is the Constitution, right? And right here, he says here on, look at the date on this, December 19th, 2020, right here, 6:42 a.m. early in the morning, December 19th, 2020. Now you don't get out of your bed at 6:42 a.m. in the morning and tweet when you haven't been thinking or about what you're doing, not just all night or the night before, but probably all week, right? And this is December 19th. The actual march was, as he says here in his tweet, January 6th. So if you look at December 19th to January 6th, that's a long time. That's a long time for you to project. And anyone who's done any form of promotion or exhibition, it takes weeks of planning in order for you to do a march, an exhibition, a demonstration, a protest. It takes a lot of planning. And right here, December 19th, Donald Trump tweeted at 6:42 a.m. in the morning from his then Twitter account on social media and says, I don't even want to read it. You read it. But it talks about releasing 36-page report alleging election fraud more than sufficient, he said. To what? Swing victory to Trump. Then he says a great report, blah, 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 okay? And he says it's impossible to have lost the 2020 election, yet he lost by 7 million votes. 7 million votes, right? And he says, watch this. Here's his reaction. Here's his intent. And here is what he actually carried out. Dated December 19th, this tweet, right? And he says, big protests in D.C. He didn't say small. He said big. Big protests in D.C. on what? January 6th. And then he says, be there. Will be wild. Will be wild. This is the President of the United States saying this. If you've got, and he, as he likes to claim, if you've got 70 odd million votes, or even if you have 50 million votes, even if you have 10 million votes, and 10 million votes equals 10 million people, and you're telling people as the President of the United States to be there, will be wild. This is why we have to listen. It's not just about an impeachment. It's not about, really not about just Donald Trump. Donald Trump could not have planned this by himself. He would need every one of his family. Well, not everyone, but you know, the ones who actually stick close to him. Okay, you know who they are, right? He's going to need his staff. He's going to need the GOP, most of the GOP party. He's going to need a lot of people, lawyers and publicists and lots, a big team. And he actually carried out everything what he said in this tweet from December 19th, 2020. Long time. You think he just woke up on December 19th at 6:42 a.m. and just decided to put out this tweet? No. He actually planned before December 19th. So they could actually say he planned for the whole month, period. At minimum, a whole month of planning this event. And he said, big protests in D.C. on January 6th. Be there, will be wild. Will be wild. And you remember he's also, through the impeachment trial, they showed the video where he spoke and said that let's march. March where? March onto what? The Capitol. Let's march onto the Capitol. Let's march to the Capitol. Same thing. Onto, to, same thing. So he actually, on that day, when they got there, he took the stage and he took the microphone and he said, right, this is what we're going to do. We're going to march to the Capitol. Then he actually said more instructions. He gave more instructions, more intent, and said, we're going to fight like what? Hell. So he's, if you check his tweet from here, when it says will be wild from December 19th, then on the actual day what they got there, he says, what, fight like hell. He even told them, don't be weak. Don't be weak. So what is it that they do not understand as lawyers, state law officials, even Pelosi talking about praying for Donald Trump? Yeah, you prayed for Donald Trump, right? And Donald Trump almost got hold of every single person in that building on that day. Almost. And this is why, if they allow Donald Trump to be acquitted, because the GOP party, the Republicans, cannot stand up to the fact that their lawless, racist, fascist, KKK statutes, policies, mindsets are under threat. Under threat. If Donald Trump is convicted. So they will stand and protect lawlessness, racism, fascism, right-wing lies, even in this photo, to think that they are above people who are shades of brown. They only have to look at Menelin and the power of Menelin to see who really has the power, who really has the strength. You only have to look at who created the first alphabet. And I've done videos on this. Who created the first alphabet? Who created the understanding of astronomy? Who created the biggest architecture in the world, like pyramids? Who were the first dynasties, the real kings and queens of human civilization? Who has the oldest human DNA? It's not pink people, because nobody is white. Get a sheet of white paper and match it 100%. Because color doesn't lie. It's not like Donald Trump. It's not like GOP or Republicans. It does not lie. Color is color. It does not lie. Most people are pink and shades of brown. Shades of brown. That's why you have people who are light and have people who are brown, different shades of brown. Dark brown, light brown. Okay? But no one is white. Most of them, even Donald Trump, is pink. 100%. Go check with a sheet of white paper and a sheet of pink paper and see which one you match closer to, okay? So this whole United States of America, which is supposed to be united, but has never been united, because you have racist ideologies, you have racist people, mindsets, who even will hold up the very Bible and then tell you that because I hold up the Bible. Now, here's another thing would come in, you know, in conclusion to, you know, this video. Donald Trump's holding up the Bible. You know why Donald Trump's holding up the Bible? This is just my opinion. But my opinions are pretty accurate, okay? Watch this. Donald Trump's holding up the Bible standing outside of the church because Donald Trump is saying to the event, he's saying this for a number of reasons. This is reason number one. Yeah, okay. Reason number one is Donald Trump is saying, I need the evangelical right-wing people, okay? So I'm holding up the Bible because, I need evangelical right-wing people. I'm also holding up the Bible because Jesus is white and all the disciples in the Bible are white. So the power is white, okay? You get me? He's also saying that you can trust me. I'm holding up the Bible, even though it has no title on the front of the Bible or the cover or nothing. But I'm holding it up because guess what, right? I am saying that the power is with my people, my patriots. That's why when he says the word patriots, he's not talking about black and brown people as patriots. He's saying if you're not a Republican and you're not GOP and you're not fascist or racist, you're not a patriot. But I'm going to close this video and I'm going to say that Donald Trump really is going to have a judgment day. Believe it. GOP will have a judgment day. All Republicans will have a judgment day. When you sit and think that all of the blood and all of the slavery and all of the wickedness, the lynching, the raping, the imprisonment of people who are older than you. You talk about Christopher Columbus' BS that he discovered, the Caribbean. How can you discover people older than you? Christopher Columbus would have to be older than everybody on that island. How can you go to an island and actually find people there? Can I discover the White House? Just go there and say, right, I've just discovered the White House with people in there. Or, I've just discovered Australia. It's ridiculous. It's nonsense. The whole history of America does not actually make sense. Especially when the natives of America are actually Red Indians. In fact, they're Ama Indians. And Ama Indians are not just the founders of the real founders and natives of America, but they're also the real founders and natives of the Caribbean. Even China. You can do the research. Ama Indians and Africans are the first people of human civilization, period. Without a fact. And with lots of facts worldwide. And like I said, even with meddling, that proves it. Because most people, without certain power of meddling, you couldn't even live in Africa. You could not live in Israel. You could not, and Israel is Africa, okay? You couldn't live in Sudan. You couldn't live in other countries. And you don't get anything bigger than Africa. And guess what? Where is like I said in the previous videos, where do you get the Garden of Eden? Where's the Garden of Eden? Garden of Eden cannot be, see elephants and zebras running around America or Canada or England, do you? Where's all the exotic fruits, species, trees, herbs of the land? So it's time in 2021 for a reset. That's why the cosmos, and we just had a new full moon on the 11th of February. The whole cosmos and universe is resetting this great conjunction that's bringing these things up in order for it to be addressed, in order for the Nancy stories and the the racism and the fascism bullshit to stop. Bullshit history. Bullshit politicians. Bullshit lawyers. Bullshit laws. Bullshit religions. There is no religion or denomination on planet Earth older than Africa, older than pyramids, older than hieroglyphs, older than papyrus, older than kings and queens of the first dynasties they call mummies. Mummies? Mummies? You won't even call them kings and queens of Africa. You won't even use, even in the very Bible, you won't use the name Africa. In the Bible, you won't, you, that's why he's holding up this phony Bible. Because this phony Bible's been written by Christianity of Constantine and white racist people who called people of Africa slaves and beasts and uneducated. And we're going to colonize them. We're going to teach them how to live. How can you teach them to live when they're older than you and they created architecture and pyramids and monumental buildings you can't even build today? With all the latest technology, you cannot build it today. It's time for people to wake up. Wake up and understand what really Donald Trump is trying to do. And for Lil Wayne and these rappers to support him? That's insanity. That's because you don't you smoke too much weed and drugs. You don't understand your history. You don't know who you are. You don't even know who the real kings and queens are of this earth, historically and factually. That's why in 2021, Donald Trump, at some point in 2021, mark my words, will go to jail. If you're on YouTube, please leave your likes, share, comments, subscribe. Share it with your friends and family. Thank you for listening. Cyber Earth.